Hello, I'm Starlight. Welcome to my channel. In this video, I will be taking a look at HTC Vive Pro 2 and comparing it to my current headset, the Valve Index. This HTC was provided by my friends Simplex over at m2podcast.pl. It's a Polish podcast. If you are Polish, then you are heartily recommended to check it out. This is recorded on the HTC Vive, so apologies if it sounds different than my usual videos, because this is the pure unfiltered sound from the HTC Vive, and usually I use my Index to record. As usual, you will have the performance indicators of FPS VR somewhere above me. This video isn't about performance. I want to take a look at the headset, its ergonomics, its visuals, and try to compare it to the Index in basically the aspects that I consider important for gaming. So field of view, edge-to-edge clarity, sweet spots, etc., etc. I have set the SteamVR settings to 100%. However, the HTC software, which you need to install to use this headset, messes this up arbitrarily. So it does some weird check at start of your performance and sets the resolution accordingly. I will use the FPS VR to measure the current resolution we are rendering at. So FPS VR, basic, and you can see that I have my resolution set to 100%, and for DCS also no change. This is different from my usual setup, but the Vive Pro is so high resolution that it needs its own treatment. So let's detect the resolution. And currently we are rendering at almost 3000 by 3000 per eye. So it's already a really high resolution. And like I said, the Vive is currently the best resolution on the market. In the Vive software, I have set the software to the 90 Hz ultra preset, so that we have the best visual quality possible, which Vive can do. I don't know if it will be visible on the recording, but in the headset, oh boy, this is good. This is definitely good. So as this is the best resolution on the market currently, I can read practically everything in the cockpit from my standard starting position. So for example here, 04, 06, 03, heading select, which is not particularly readable, 264, let's check, and it's 264. Basically, everything is clear. I can read this text, nose, left, right, half, and nose, left, right, half. This text is a bit blurry, so I wouldn't say I could read it if I didn't know what it says. However, on the HUD, you can read pretty much everything. You can easily read the course and time to target, etc., etc. So basically, you can read everything in the cockpit. And this is about the resolution. However, there is some caveat to that. The caveat is that this headset has a little stereo overlap. What does it mean? The area that you have presented to your eyes should overlap. So in this overlap area, you have the stereo vision. And basically, both eyes can see the same point from different angles. In this headset, this area is, like I said, really small. If I look on the bright object like this sky, I can literally see some arcs made by edges of the lenses. It's not very noticeable, but you can see that. A game like Half-Life Alyx, for example, where you have all white intro, and this is like something smeared on the lens or something. You will, of course, not see it on the recording. If you think about it, it's something like if you look forward, that you can see your nose. And this is something similar, that some ghost image of your nose. So if I look straight and don't move my head, and I'm using my eyes to look around. So here, top row of the MFD is already blurry. Also, if I look left to the left DDI, advisory and bit is completely unreadable. Here I can barely make out the harm override. I'm still trying to look on the ELS button. I can read this text, it's 48 and M0.10, but it's all blurry. It starts to be distorted horizontally and having ghosts. Just EXP1 has ghosts, etc. For someone who is coming from the index, this is weird, because in the index you have much bigger stereo overlap. It's still not as big as it was in original Vive, but you have bigger area and you can look around with your eyes. If I look on this radar and turn my head a bit, now it's blurry. Now it's clear. Now it's blurry. So basically, if you look straight, you have really good clarity. You can read pretty much everything in the cockpit, but you must turn your head. So no quick glances, because if you try to quick glance, you will see some ghosting and some images. Another example is I have this AOA indexer. If I look directly on the HUD while I'm landing, I will see the AOA indexer ghosted in my field of vision on the HUD, which is annoying. This headset has Godrays and glare problem. The Godrays are really distracting, because if you move your head just a bit, the text is getting more blurry because of the Godrays and the little stereo overlap I mentioned. So basically, you need to look straight at things. And when you look straight at things, the resolution is magnificent. Like I said, I can read pretty much everything in the cockpit. After you put the headset on, you immediately notice that the picture you see is a rectangle with slightly rounded borders. It's different than in Index, for example. If you see the borders in the Index, it's here, not here. If I set my headset that I have now toggle mirrors on top here, so this edge here is an edge of my headset, like so. I'm looking directly on this HUD thingy here, and I can see blurry, but I can see the left mirror, the edge of left mirror. The bottom part of the left mirror is my edge of my vision, and on the right it's more blurry, but I can also see the edge of the mirror. And at the bottom I can see the SA page. I can barely make out the writings. I can see them, but very faintly. So basically, I see the pedals, I see the lower, I see the MPCD, and basically the canopy bow is my my edges, and at the bottom it's the bottom of the MPCD. This all look excellent in this headset. The detail. There are some jaggies because I turned the anti-aliasing off, but they are not that noticeable, and the picture is really, really great.
Those are my thoughts on the HTC Vive Pro 2. I hope you enjoyed the video. Let me know down in the comments, like and subscribe for more VR content in the future. I'm Starlight, and this was your portal to virtual worlds.